wondering if there is an attempt for those two countries to work together. There's been a history of those two countries not working together, but at this time, is there an effort to make that happen? And would it be great if it did?
And that's good. We have four questions. Mr. Ogata, maybe can you respond to whichever ones you like, not in particulars, about the concerns over Fukushima, and then the others if you like to also.
So I think I have two questions.
Yeah.
First, Fukushima. Yes. 6 years ago, very big earthquake happened in Japan, and after that, and after big aftermath, the Fukushima Daiichi reactor destroyed, and radioactivities spread all over. This is a very sad and very big tragedy in Japan. And this, nowadays, more than 800,000 people evacuated from the areas. But in spite of that, the Japanese government tried to hide the damages, real damage, and tried to confirm the importance of the nuclear power. It's a very long way. So more than 60% of the Japanese people are against nowadays nuclear power. It is correct. And after the incident of earthquake in Japan, there are 54 nuclear power stations. All of them have been stopped. But last year, Japanese government admitted to restart. And they have a great tendency to start more nuclear power stations. So we are engaging in the activities against nuclear powers. Stop nuclear powers. Stop nuclear weapons. And I think this public opinion is much more important in Japan. And so we want to know, share our very tragic experience with you and with all over the world. And because radiation never controlled socially and physically. So this is our great lesson. So we are fighting against the restart of nuclear weapons, and electricity simply should be created by the natural ways. This is our direction. And second question is about history. Yes, this is very, very important. And especially Japanese government, especially Abe, Mr. Abe, he himself is a very reactionary ideology. And he belonged to Japan Congress, which beautified the war of aggression and colonization in the past, saying that Japan's war of aggression, including the Pacific War with the United States, is a defensive war. And Japan was obliged to wage war in the situation that ABCD countries, that is American, British, and China, and Dutch. ABC countries encircled against Japan. For that, Japan waged the war. And as a result, war liberated Asian countries. This is the forsake of Asian nations. It is completely wrong ideology. But Abe itself believed this So for that, one of the most important and grave reasons that the Japan had a very difficult relationship with Republic of Korea and China, even North Korea, that this is completely against the international standard, completely against the standard of the principles of the United Nations, even the United Nations Charter. So we are fighting against such reactionary and very bad ideology, wrong ideology of Mr. Abe. So without paving away this wrong ideology, the real relationship and right relationship between Japan and Republic of Korea and China never come. So for that, we are fighting for the just recognition of the history. Thank you.
Question one. Pyongyang역정이 도움이 되냐고 물어보셨는데 실제로 저희가 이 사드가 배치하는 거 이런 것들은 다 국가적으로 협정이 있어야 되는 건데 그런 사인이나 그런 거 없이 하고 뭐 군사 기밀이라고 하면서 이것이 우리 남한을 보호하는 거라고 그렇게 국민들을 속이면서 계속 정치를 해나오는 이 사람들이 문제이긴 하지만 그래도 법적으로는 이런 것들이 필요합니다. 그래서 저희가 지금 투쟁을 하고 있지만은 우리 민변 변호사들이 함께 해서 지금 법적으로 그곳에 사드 배치는 안 된다. 왜냐하면은 원불교 성지가 있기 때문이다라고도 말하고 있고 또 이러한 문서가 서로 오고 간 것이 없다. 국가적으로 이렇게 하려면은 예산도 많이 들고 경제적으로도 그리고 우리의 모든 국민들의 세금이 들어가는 거기 때문에 국회에서 당론으로 채택해서 이 문제를 해결해야 한다고 하지만 당론으로 채택도 안 할 뿐더러 정치하는 사람들은 표만 중요시 여기기 때문에 지금 이런 문제들이 원활하게는 되어 있지 않습니다. 그래서 저희는 사드는 원천적으로 무효라고 외치고 있습니다.
Okay. Peace treaty will definitely will help. Legally, this type of treaty or this type of agreement that has to be written document. We have not seen any written document about that deployment so far. We have been asking for it. They have not produced it to it. And when they said it's a national security, so they cannot give it to her. But you know, we said let us just see the picture of it. We haven't even seen the glimpse of it. So we think this is illegally done. The National Democratic Lawyers Guild have been suing and placing a petition under the court following the legal procedures. They're saying first it's a holy sacred land, and legally speaking, it is supposed to be untouched. So we are basing on that, there is a petition. Second, it never went through the congressional ratification process. So we are saying this is a very important and a lot of money is going into it. We need a national ratification. Third, there was no briefing or hearing on this matter, legally speaking, so we need that. We need to go back to the democratic process and then we need to follow the steps. So we are saying now that the THAAD deployment should be nullified because it has no legal grounds to hold on. And that's what we are saying right now.
Okay, thank you. Two questions. Mm-hmm. 저희가 평화협정에 도움이 된다는 것은 정말 우리는 남북한이 통일되기를 원하고 있어요. 그리고 남북한에 대화하기를 원하고 있고 그런 모든 정책들을 써주기를 원하고 있는데 지금 대통령이 누가 되느냐에 따라서 이것이 평화적으로 한 발짝 한 발짝 갔다가 통일 쪽으로 갔다가 다시 물러서고 하는데 한국에는 우리 박근혜가 문제였고 또 미국에 또 기대를 했는데 트럼프 또 일본의 아베 모두가 독재적인 정권을 쓰고 있기 때문에 어렵긴 하지만 그래도 저희는 희망을 가지고 있습니다. 왜? 왜냐하면 저희 스승님들이 통일도 될 것이고 앞으로는 인지가 발달하기 때문에 이렇게 먼저 싸움을 거는 나라가 망한다고 했습니다. 그래서 저희는 그걸 생각하고 있고 또 물질이 개벽되니까 정신을 개벽돼야 되는데 물질의 노예 생활을 하고 있는 강대국들을 언제까지 끝까지 갈 수는 없는 거거든요. 변화하기 때문에.
So we do say that, you know, peace treaty will be helpful because if there is a peace treaty, there is no need to be a confrontational policies between these two countries. And then we'll have a no ground to stand. When earlier presidents in Korea were walking towards the peace and peaceful dialogue and diplomacy between South and North Korea. However, since the Park Geun-hye president came, there was no more hope for the diplomacy. So we were looking into the U.S. and then U.S. had Trump. And then when you're looking at Japan, you're seeing Abe. So all of them are like sort of a dictational and undemocratic, and we don't know if this is really early on in the horizon. However, in our belief and one Buddhist teaching, they said what rises if you start a provocation, then you will die with you will end with a provocation. Provocation meaning you will lose your minds. When the things change and develop, our ideology, our minds will also supposed to develop, and eventually people will see the bright side of the peace. Thank you.
저희 한국이 합동 군사훈련을 하는데 이거에 대해서 북한이 어떻게 생각하고 있는지 사실 저는 모르죠. 그런데 북한에서는 이것이 위험이라고 생각을 해요. 그렇기 때문에 더 미사일 실험도 하고 발사도 해보고 그러는 건데 정말 저는 이 미국이 우방이라고 하면서 우리나라를 그렇게 하는 거에 대해서 못마땅해요. 그래서 여러분들이 미국에 살고 계시지만 이렇게 먼저 선각자 역할로 평화를 사랑하는 여러분들이 존경스럽고 여러분들 같은 2세, 3세 계속 나오면서 이게 널리 널리 퍼질 때 많은 사람들이 여기에 동참을 할 때 평화는 반드시 온다고 생각을 하고 지금 저 북한 체제는 그렇게밖에 할 수 없는 그거를 이해를 해주면서 서로 대화를 하고 교류를 하면은 통일이 되어지리라고 생각합니다.
So the joint military exercise is really, I don't know how the North Korea will receive it because I never been to, I mean, I cannot speak on behalf of the North Korea how they view the joint military exercise. But if I were them, I would have felt threatened and angry that they are doing it on the border, and this is very provocative. So. We say so in the end, the military exercises really hurt the relationship between South Korea and North Korea and North Korea and the U.S. It's never gonna go into the good results. They're knowing that they are doing this. So as an ally country, as a people who are supposed, I mean, as a country that supports the justice and peace and democracy, quote unquote, I don't understand why the U.S. government does that into Korea. Why do they keep doing these military exercises here in doing? So you have to understand that North Korea, what they are doing is not a provocation. the mindless provocation, but they have their reasons for it. And we understand it now. So only the North and South Korea's relationship will benefit through the diplomacy and through the exchange. And we are firmly believing in it. And hopefully, as a peaceful pioneers, all of you, that you can disseminate this idea that you cannot threaten, and scare tactics never work. You know, we have to work with our enemy through the diplomacy, through the exchange, that you will have to disseminate it, and then one day that the people will really, the government will really listen to the people.
Thank you. Question four.
Japan과 우리 한반도가 우리 한국이 같이 이렇게 우방으로 좋은 정치를 할 수 있겠냐고 물어보는데요. 아베 정권 그 정치에 많은 사람들이 속고 있어요. 근데 일본은 섬나라잖아요. 그래서 우리나라를 끝까지 약탈하려고 하는데 36년간이나 우리를 속국으로 이렇게 했지만 앞으로는 그렇게 되지 않을 거라고 믿고 있고 그리고 미국 아베 정권이 막 위안부에 대해서나 그 모든 것들을 거짓말 정치를 하고 있어요. 거기에 대해서 저희가 계속 반발을 하고 있고 교과서에도 막 그 전쟁만이 자기네들이 살길이고 전쟁만이 우리를 도와주는 거고 미국을 도와준다 근데 전혀 그렇지 않은 것을 우리 한 사람 한 사람 인지가 깨어났기 때문에 그걸 믿지 않습니다. 그래서 그전하고 다르게 지금은 우리가 정신이 개벽돼서 깨달음으로 가고 있기 때문에 아마 이렇게 서로 좋은 사이로 하려고 저희들은 끝까지 노력을 하고 있습니다. 그래서 이게 일본 측에서도 저희 성주 촛불에 여러 번 찾아왔었고 저희 집에서 2박 3일간 이렇게 숙박하면서도 이야기 하신 분들도 있고 그래요. 절대 사드가 안 된다고.
So under the Abe administration, yes, it is true that there was a hostile relationship. Not because of the Korea fought with the Japan, but it was because of the 36 years of the colonization. And there are a lot of problems in history, as Mr. Agata said, you know, comfort woman issues and occupation issues. There are so many wrong the understanding about the history. But the war and confrontation, as I said, is not the way that we are promoting to go. We are not trying to in conflict with people of Japan either. We are trying to, as a people who are enlightened, we are trying to understand that, you know, we can work together. There are strong solidarity movements already established with the people, between the people, if not the government, between the government. So some already we had a couple of visitors, couple of times the Citizens Alliance visited us in Songju, and they stayed every time, 2 nights and 3 days, and we worked together, we had a lot of photos, and exchanges already is happening.
We have just about run out of time for this panel, but I wanted to give you one last opportunity if either of our speakers would have a brief and last brief comment. Would either of you like to have a concluding comment?
We are very happy to be with a Korean friend together because this is the most important demonstration that people to creations between Japan and Korea is excellent. Thank you.
Finally, 저희는 조그만한 전쟁도 모든 것을 죽입니다. 그렇지만 평화는 모든 것을 살리기 때문에 조그만한 전쟁도 이 세계에서 완전히 종식되고 이 평화만이 한 걸음 한 걸음 나아가서 온 세계가 다 평화로웠으면 좋겠습니다. 감사합니다.
However small conflict, military excursions kill a lot of people, a lot of living things, and peace so makes a lot of things thrive. So we should really focus our minds on peace and try not to ignore however small conflict, if there is any. We have to be mindful that is can be causing another war and conflict, and we have to really build solidarity so that there will be peace at the end for all.
Thank you for Dr. and Reverend Kim, the wonderful translator Julianne Lee.